The University of Kigali started in 2013 by promoters, and it is a private high learning institution which has a target of becoming a very brilliant university, which is an international university. And in its target is to make a positive change in the labor force. Positive change in the labor force. Even you can see it in his motto, which says labor for the future. How unique the University of Kigali is comparing to the rest of the setup of the high learning institution in Rwanda. The University of Kigali, when we look at the standards as regards to the quality of education, the one standard says, let me mention one, says that academic staff should have at least 15% of them being of PhD holders. University of Kigali has a total of 41% of PhD holders, senior lecturers and professors, which is the highest ratio in Rwanda. I may even say in the region, because the way I know, we have the highest ratio in terms of quality of academic staff, which makes the uniqueness of the University of Kigali. Something else which makes the uniqueness of the University of Kigali is about the ratio of local and foreigners. The promoters and even the management want to make the university more international. Making it more international, the university recruits international staff. And today, when we look at the ratio, we are at 31% of foreigners. And it's not only foreigners, we are making sure that we are getting the right professors, the right senior lecturers, the right professionals who can join the university to make it different. In addition to that also, we have our programs that are unique. If I can start from the certificates, professional certificates, international professional certificates, I can mention the CPA, for example. CPA, when we look at the Rwandan setup, the government of Rwanda trusted the University of Kigali due to its quality of programs and quality of staff. And today, we are the ones, the University of Kigali is the one training all the government accountants at all levels in CPA. If the government trusts, it means that the quality is there. In addition to that, the undergraduate is having the uniqueness. Even the graduate school, which is the master's, and we applied also for the PhD programs. Meaning that even though the university is young, comparing to other universities in the Rwandan setup of higher education, we are doing more and even more to make the university a setup of a good university. Last not least, we are offering 3 intakes in the University of Kigali. Normally, we have September intake, January intake, and May intake. And currently, we are receiving students of May intake. To allow the flexibility of studying for students, we have those students who can study in the morning, those who can study in the evening, and those who can study in the weekend, in the course of facilitating students to learn or to study according to their availabilities. In addition, or last, in terms of payment, we are flexible in terms of payment of tuition fees to facilitate students, to facilitate guardians, to facilitate parents to pay for their beneficiaries.
My name is Miriam. I'm a student in University of Kigali. The first time I knew University of Kigali was on a TV in Uganda. The students had gone to debate. They were participating in the East African Inter-University Debate Championship. And that's where I saw the University of Kigali students, and they knew what they were doing. That's when I got the interest. Compared to other universities, this university tries to improve on the English language. It makes it holistic for everyone all over the world to come and study. Unlike other universities, most of the time they don't emphasize English as a language, but here, because they want to accommodate everyone, they emphasize English as a language, so it makes it more comfortable for the locals and even the students in other countries.
We are not bringing these professors from abroad because the locals cannot. No, it's not that. Mm-hmm. We want to make the university more international.
Okay.
More international, mm-hmm. not because the locals are not able, mm-hmm. but to make the university international,
okay.
to make that whoever wants to send the kid, the son or the daughter outside, feels that the University of Kigali is offering. Mm-hmm. The professors we want to get from outside, mm-hmm. they are brought to the University of Kigali. Mm-hmm. Why going outside? Mm-hmm. That's the rationale of making the university more international. Mm-hmm. That's one. Two.
They even become ambassadors.
Yes, exactly. They will become even ambassadors. Yeah. Even internationalization of the university, mm-hmm. when you look at the students, the nationalities, mm-hmm. we are having 29 nationalities mm-hmm. here in the University of Kigali. Okay. And also the capacity building is there. Yes, we are facilitating our staff to do their PhDs.
Okay.
There are even some who have completed their PhDs, okay. and others are still ongoing. They are very advanced. Mm. That's how the university works.
I would love to continue with my master's here because the corporate social responsibility program of this university makes it possible to help good students that get first-class degrees. They give them scholarships for masters here. So if I manage to get a first class degree and I have a scholarship, I'll surely continue from here.
The promoters who created the university, in their spirit, in their vision, is to have a positive impact on the society. This is part of the corporate social responsibility of the university. They are not money-oriented, as some may be, but they, as promoters, they made this university not as money-oriented university, rather making a change on the society. That's how, we don't have any sponsor, but the promoters set the criteria,
standard, yeah.
the standards to secure that scholarship,
yeah.
merit. Mm. If someone gets the first class at undergraduate, that one can get sponsored at the University of Kigali.
Mm.
It is automatic. Mm. Then proceeds to the master's, the graduate school.
Mm.
I'm sure as the PhD gets also accredited or allowed to be rolled out, those will be getting first class at master's.
Mm.
I'm sure promoters will allow them to continue with the PhD without paying as a scholarship. Because
yeah.
even for the Miss Rwanda, it is in the same spirit. If ladies have gone through a competition, have gone through scrutinizing from the national level, then perform, then get at the level of being the best, considering the criteria which were set by the team which was selecting, the University of Kigali said these ladies need to get helped, strengthened for them to achieve their projects, because each has a project to achieve.
Yeah.
That's how education being the key for the success, that's how the University of Kigali resolved to grant them scholarship. Whoever joins the University of Kigali gets a scholarship for the achievement of their projects. Do what we call tracer studies. Tracer study means to check what they are doing outside there. Currently, we are having even a survey we are conducting with the NIT, which is the National Institute of information technology from India, at which he has a branch here in Kigali, yeah. to assess, to survey the skills gap in the special economic zone, okay. to check how is the, what is the skills gap, to inform us, the result will inform the University of Kigali. We are working with RDB and the University of Kigali and the NIT, will inform the University of Kigali on which short course programs can we start mm-hmm. to fill in the gap. Mm-hmm. What can we do in order to strengthen, to review the existing programs? Mm-hmm. Or what can we start as a new program yeah. to address the gap? Meaning that whatever we are doing, we are sure that we follow up outside what our students are doing, what our graduates are doing through the internship coordinators.